Hello, and welcome to my short introduction on how to code with DIP switches only. How did this start? Well, I started about wondering what would be the minimum size that you could do an Atari 2600 demo with. Since we're talking about ROM here, it's always decoded in the power of 2, so it would be a power of 2 number of bytes. The conclusion for me was 32 bytes, since less would not fit a hardware initialization routine which you need at the 2600, and also the code that you have to have for video frame syncing, and you also want to include some kind of small demo effect. What we're talking about here is the Atari 2600. It's released in 1977, has a 1.2 6502 compatible CPU, 128 bytes of RAM, 4K of ROM, address space for cartridges that could be expanded using bank switching techniques. And you've got a few graphic capabilities, like two player sprites that are 8-bit in size, three missile sprites that are 1-bit in size. You've got 40-bit of playfield graphics, that's 1/4 of the resolution of the sprites, and you've got, in our case, 128 colors. But there was something missing when we are taking a look at it. 32 bytes is really not much, but I want to show how minimal and hardcore this is. Somewhat that shows the real programmer, as defined, as, for example, by XKCD. Well, and I don't even need a needle. I just need a finger. That is enough for DIP switch programmable read-only memory. Something that looks like this. What we've got here, that's 32 DIP switches. If the switch is down, that's on the bit of the ID. Highest bit, lowest bit. If the bit is down, it's set to 1. So this is an 8-5. And the address decoding is done also down, not across, as you know from the bastard operator from hell. And so the memory decoding starts here, goes down to there, goes up to the next row, and ends here. So all you knowing the 6502 would know this. This is your reset vector. So how does it work? We've got a 5-bit address decoder that selects one of those 32 8-bit DIP switches. These 8-bit data are written to the bus if the chip select signal has been encoded. Otherwise, it would collect with the I/O chips, collide with the I/O chips. And we've got to use diodes to make sure that there will be no short-circuiting, or known as ghosting. This also means there's no cheating possible, since this is so simple, their hardware. No programmable components were used, so you only can do is use these 32 bytes of ROM. And since there's no address decoding done, this means that these 32 bytes will be repeated over and over again, 128 times, inside the addressable ROM space. This will become important later on. So, the software is intended for an NTSC system. I've brought one here with me, because the 262 video lines of an NTSC signal are easier to do than a 212 video line signal of PAL for the reasons of counting. Because you can count the 265 lines by overflowing an 8-bit register. There are 4 lines already needed to create the async signal. And in our case, the sync signal, also the routine, will be wasting 2 additional lines so that we get up to the 262 lines. Doing this in PAL with 212 lines is not that easy, and you would waste some valuable space. Also, this works on a PAL system, since 80 Hz PAL is handled by most of the TVs and monitors, and only the color table is different. And the color table of the NTSC version is just a bit nicer. So, and when we now take a look at the software, the opcodes you can use in a 30-byte demo is rather limited. These are the table of all the instructions that the CPU decodes. And since 3-byte instructions really don't make any sense, they are typically used to load something from the ROM, so you would need something, a table you load from. You don't have space for this. Also, you don't really have this 3-byte opcodes. This will also be wasting another byte that you need, and every byte is sacred when you're coding 32 bytes. This is what I recommend to look at. Some of this, like break and push accumulator, might be not really good, but it could be working. So now a bit of background from the ideas to show you some of the tricks that were discovered or invented doing a 32-byte demo. As I already showed on the picture, on the end of the memory space are the interrupt vector and the reset vector. On the 2600, you need to initialize the hardware yourself by writing to a specific zero page address area. Typically, you'd just clear the whole zero page, since this is shorter, instead of trying to figure out really what part partition you need to write. Writing more doesn't hurt, and you already also clean up your RAM as well, which also isn't initialized quite in this way. So, and now let's look how this can be achieved. A typical simplified routine, that was one of the ideas that came up really rather early, was to go for load the accumulator and the X register in one go using an undocumented opcode, and then write the zero page over and over again and increment your register loop until you've got everything cleaned. You could go something for 1 byte shorter if you replace the storing to zero page by just pushing on the stack, since the stack is by hardware mirrored into the same area as the zero page. So this is 7 bytes in total, or it would be 6 bytes in total when we are taking the push accumulator into account. It can even be done with less, using some tricks and knowing what you're doing. We are using this push that I already introduced. And what we are doing there is we don't know really what value the accumulator has on reset. It's not initialized. It can be any value between 0 and 255. So we need to clean it out. But since we're running in a loop, we can do it with a 1-byte opcode, one by one. Just push the accumulator down. And we're checking at the end of the loop by checking the stack register now. The stack register is one of the few registers that is really initialized during the reset. And it's on a defined value of FD, if I remember it correctly. So it will clear up down the zero page. And the first 8 bytes might contain some garbage. But this is something that stores in RAM, and you don't even have really something, you can't do something out of the RAM, because you have to do something to write there, prepare it, and this can be done in 32 bytes. You can prove me wrong, but I think you will lose, again, too much of your valuable 32 bytes of ROM. Also, this wasn't my idea. This was done by Omega Matrix from Atari Age. Thanks for saving me this 1 byte. I needed it. So, and also quite something that's quite interesting is the reset loop. It's rather, it's not important where I enter the loop. It can be any of the first 3 bytes. I just even can enter the third one. I just check it and then loop over and over again. So it's my reset vector doesn't have to point to, just has to point to any of those three. This will be also become important later on. Because now we're talking about mirroring. And I've got 4 bytes that are for special use of the CPU. The interrupt vector isn't really used, so this is rather easy. So what we can now have to do is to come up with something that we want to do with the reset vector. In my first steps of coding, I was just skipping this one with the 3-byte instruction. So I had 3 bytes that were one for the skip instruction and the other bytes for the reset vector that I couldn't use for code. But then I came to into account, if we just take a look at the code, this code is relocatable. So it doesn't really matter where it is in RAM, or where it is in the ROM area, sorry. So it can be at any point because every jump is relative to the address where we are now. And so we have to come up with something that can be used maybe out of this code as a reset vector, and still this whole program makes sense. I started by taking every F starting hex value, and the first one didn't work, so I tried the second one, and let's remember if we use this as our reset vector. So we are now rotating our code. So this would be the final 2 bytes would be the interrupt vector, which isn't used. The penultimate 2 bytes are used for the reset vector. Now our reset vector jumps to this address, to the reset routine. And in this way, I'm using the reset vector both as code and as the reset vector, which got me an incredible 3 additional bytes. So this is what this code that he's shown you looks like running. And by just flipping a single bit, it looks like this. You can do more animation. For those who want to know, I'm using all the 3 registers to write down to the accumulator X and Y index registers to get some animation. And if I'm this binary pattern, if I also write this one with the same value as the color register, then I get a more fluent animation. But since I wanted to show that I can do something with every one of those 3, I have taken those for the original compo entry for the deadline. But now I offer you a challenge. You can win one of my boards. Here are the rules. You visit me, you take an official cheat sheet, which includes the opcode table that I've shown, also my code as an example. You write down your own code in hex, you assemble your code by hand, you dip it in, and when it runs, I write the code down into a file that's also compatible for the emulator or Harmony cartridge, so we can view it on the big screen in the 4K intro compo, old school, where you then submit your intro to, of course. And the highest scoring entry of those 32 bytes wins one of those boards, if there are at least 3 entries. Because I don't want the one guy that says, yeah, I'm doing something, a sole winner, because he eliminates the competition by just announcing that he will go. There are some people I would. So, thanks for watching. I'm now open for questions. You can come to me, you can try it out if you already have an idea what you want to do, what you want to dip in. And this concludes the official part, or if there are questions that are about maybe for the public, for the viewers on the stream, then you can ask them now. We've got a very nice guy with a microphone. So just raise your hand. Or just nail me down with questions afterwards. And also maybe a final note. When I was at work going for lunch, when the idea with the dip switches hit me, and the rest of the day I was in a very good mood. So thank you. Jetzt kommt nichts mehr. Ihr könnt aufstehen, ihr könnt rumkommen, spielen, ihr könnt noch irgendwelche Fragen stellen, was geht, was nicht geht.